And with the state title on the line Saturday night, we'll have more stacks and highlights coming up from the St. Johnsbury Academy Hilltoppers. New 7 starts right now.
Starting today, Vermont drivers can now be ticketed for using cell phones and other devices. New 7 starts right now.
NEK Waste Management has 49 towns in their district. Each of those towns voted on a separate budget on town meeting day. Those budgets were slightly affected by Act 148. While students dream of going to school for free, Obama's plan, if all goes well, will allow students to go to any state school with their first 2 years being free of tuition. This bill was written to require the government to have a warrant before searching civilians' electronic devices, as well as their personal data.
Thank you, Nick. And as you can see, tricks and treats are already starting to trickle in here at the Lindenville Firehouse. They actually open their doors up to the public.
I'm here to deny all of these allegations. The state, their witnesses, have tried to be nice, but they lied.
21 counts. All of animal cruelty charges against horses, three of which prosecutors say were found dead. Bruce Bona, the ranch owner, was denied a motion today to suppress evidence and objected nearly all of the state's accusations.
I object to 11A.
Overruled. Admitted.
Pat Mitchell and Cindy Cady were able to see 8 horses out in the pasture at the ranch property, but they didn't see the remaining 13 horses. Each of those 8 horses, they'll tell you, had protruding ribs, vertebrae, and hindquarters, and some of them had cracked hooves.
4 hours into the trial, only one witness made it to the stand. Animal control officer Cindy Cady took pictures of the horses in March. Those photographs are being used as evidence.
When each horse was brought out, I took a headshot, aside from the left, view shot, the rear, the right side, and then both sets of hooves. This is just the rear shot of one of the horses inside in a stall. Noticeably, the backbone is sticking up higher than the hips are, you know, sunken around.
With Bona representing himself, none of his statements can be used as evidence until he takes the stand, if he decides to do so. Reporting for the Vermont Center for Community Journalism, I'm Alex Farnworth in St. Johnsbury.
This July 2015, it's mandatory recycling. It's no longer, we're here if you want to, it's you must.
The first component of three-part Act 148 requires Vermonters to separate recyclables in-house. But why?
The state agency, Department of Environmental Conservation, they were concerned that there wasn't a high enough recycling rate, especially because they were concerned that we only have one landfill.
This law requires the recycling of metal, plastics 1 and 2, glass, and cardboard. Kirby is ahead of the law and has been making changes to their transfer station since last summer.
Let's get out ahead of it then. Let's figure out what we have to do and do it. So the town of Kirby's transfer station is 2 dumpsters in a stockade. And people come on Saturday mornings and drop off their trash and go. And so what we came up with was maybe we could switch one dumpster to recycling and one dumpster to trash. And so we did that.
NEK Waste Management has 49 towns in their district. Each of those towns voted on a separate budget on town meeting day. Those budgets were slightly affected by Act 148.
Our district budget is voted on individually by each town, and because our surcharge or our tax on trash is based on the amount of trash generated, towns with larger populations typically generate more trash, and so the amount that they contribute to our budget varies because of that. We did see a slight increase in our budget compared to last year. Some of that is due in part to Act 148.
And somebody asked me after town meeting this year, they said, so why do we still have to pay Northeast Kingdom Waste Management if we're doing our recycling here by ourselves? Which is a good question, and I think it's a fair question. You know, do we need layers of redundancy? And while we do single stream, we don't recycle everything here in the town of Kirby. This recycling initiative, I think, is trying to keep everybody's landfill costs down.
According to Forbes magazine, Vermont is ranked the greenest state in the nation, and this law is the first stepping stone of an even greener future while finding ways to get everyone involved.
I mean, when you start talking about dollars and cents, people start saying, oh, wait, yeah, if I have to pay, you know, $3 for the big black trash bag, or I can throw my recycling for free, then it really makes them think, well, this is a benefit to me.
So once you're paying exactly for what you throw, I think people pay far more attention to it. It also will get people to pull out the recyclable materials that don't need to go into the landfill and take up all that space.
With the first step awaiting implementation and part two coming in 2016, lawmakers are excited to get this act underway, and they think it's a great idea.
I do, yeah, because it costs you nothing to recycle, and it costs you money to throw away trash, so why wouldn't you recycle? That we only have so much landfill capacity, and it's probably better for the environment that we use our resources correctly and we reuse them correctly if that's possible. I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer, really. I mean,
with only one running landfill in Vermont, this act is set up to limit what goes into it. Reporting for the Vermont Center for Community Journalism, I'm Alex Farnworth.
17, the number of seniors moving on after Saturday's game. 10, the number of wings the Hilltoppers earned, totaling more than the last 3 years combined. And 1, the amount of games that it all came down to.
This was a special team. You don't go 10-0 to the state championship game every year, you know. So, I think we can be competitive every year. I think we can be a team that competes, makes a playoff, makes a run every single year.
Not even the best scriptwriters could have written this story. On the opening drive, senior quarterback Colton Hugson was picked off by Middlebury, and the Tigers punched it in right after that. The Academy kept it close, with Hugson bouncing back and throwing a strike into the end zone. Going into halftime, the game was within reach. But the third and fourth quarter were a different story.
They were tougher on this field than I had expected, but they came out ready to play. Coach Lercio had them ready, and we had to answer the bell because it was a dogfight out there for four quarters.
Middlebury knew they had to capitalize against the Hilltoppers, and that happened on 4th and 21.
I hope someone's open because I don't feel like scrambling on this play. And the line gave me like 2-3 seconds, and that's all we needed. They blocked it great, and Colin made a great play.
And with that score, the book had been closed on the Hilltoppers' perfect season. Even though some players are moving on, the memories and special bond will stay with them forever.
I love them. Great season. I mean, you just can't. 10-0, it's just awesome feeling, and then coming to this and just being a part of this is an amazing feeling.
With the final score of 28-7, Middlebury repeats as Division I champs. Reporting for the Vermont Center for Community Journalism, I'm Alex Farnworth in Rutland.
Around 12,000 Blue Cross Blue Shield customers are facing complications when it comes to canceling or making adjustments to their insurance plans. The insurer says only about 5% of accounts that were renewed for 2015 were processed through Vermont Health Connect. Thanks, AJ. And a year has gone by since a local 8th grade girl, Angela Kubicki, sent a letter to Senator Joe Benning asking for Vermont to add a Latin motto. Stella Quarta Derrima Fulgeat was a requested motto, and the idea stemmed from an old Vermont. The Vermont Senate passed a new resolution that recognizes climate change as a very important issue. The Senate's resolution from earlier this week states global warming in Vermont is getting worse because of human actions. A 19-year-old male from West Charleston was back in court this afternoon for a competency hearing. Jesse, the Public Service Department is asking Fairpoint Communications for more information so they can decipher exactly how many customers did not receive bill credits for a telephone repair delay. Solar power has made a name for itself as a clean alternative to fossil fuels, but there are some drawbacks to the bulky panels. And you may think of these as just for young children, but now coloring books are all the rage for adults. In fact, these books are on the top of Amazon's bestsellers list. Claire Sebastian explains. The decision to allow RVs on all private property in Burke is back in the hands of the voters. Just that informational meeting is scheduled for June 5th at 6 p.m. The revote will take place on June 9th.
The RV vote wasn't the only controversial topic at the Burke Select Board meeting. In fact, the issue of loose dogs in several neighborhoods...
Even though flooding's not a concern, are skiers worried about the length of their season?
Well, there is a pretty...
So with a little bit of rain this morning and more coming in, do you think we're still in the clear for flooding, or should we be concerned? When do you think I'll be able to start incorporating shorts into my everyday wardrobe?
I wish I could tell you soon, but...